Recorded.
Well, good morning. Good morning. This is the Diamond Factory, and it is Monday morning. My name is Phyllis Nash. I'm your Chief Sales Officer here at Wakana, as well as one of the four co-founders. And this is the Diamond Factory, where we get together Tuesday through Friday just to start our day off with a little positivity, with like-minded people, that we're all on a same journey. And so today is Wednesday, the day that we have for our phenomenal trainer, our VP of training, that takes us to the next level, that opens our eyes to let us see some of the possibilities. And that would be none other than our own Coach Dan. Coach Dan, are you out there, Coach Dan? It's been a minute since I had the pleasure of announcing and bringing you on for our Wednesday morning call. But are you out there this morning?
Merry New Year!
All right, all right. It's so good to hear your voice. I haven't heard it in a minute. And Happy New Year to you, too.
And it's not morning where I am.
Where are you?
4 o'clock. It is 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I bring you greetings from South Africa, Cape Town, South Africa.
I'm going to kick you. I just want you to know. I'm going to let you have it.
And so let me say this. I was flying last Wednesday. The flight was supposed to land in South Africa. My flight was supposed to land at exactly 7:50 a.m. And Coach Dan's intention was to get off the plane and jump on the call and greet you from South Africa as I landed. Matter of fact, it was like 7:30, I believe, it was supposed to land. It did not land until 8:47 because it was delayed, and that's why I wasn't on. Lately, I've been traveling, and Wednesday's been that day. But that's enough of that stuff. I'm super excited. Super excited to be on the line with my family. It's been a couple of weeks. Phyllis, it feels so good to hear your voice. And guess what, y'all? We are in a new year. I'm down here speaking. I've spoken about 4 times since I've been here. Just did a pastoral session earlier this morning and getting ready to speak again tonight. Met with business leaders, all of that stuff. And one of the things I've realized here as I think about this year is that all of us, if I can be Pastor Dan for the next 60 seconds and I'm a shift, but all of us, there's 3 kind of praises for transitioning from last year to this year. The first praise was the praise that said, thank God 2022 is over. There's some of you that dealt with some stuff in 2022 and it wasn't the best stuff you had to deal with. And you're just thanking God that 22 was over. The second kind of praise is the praise that simply says, thank God I'm still here. Because many people didn't make it. Many people died. Many people didn't wake up. And so we praise God because we're still here. But the third kind of praise is where we get excited, and I wanted you to get excited. And that's the kind of praise that's a prophetic praise, is that when you thank God in advance for what he is going to do in your future. And I want you to know that the fact that you're still here, the fact that you made it through the tests and the struggles and the trials and the situations of 2022, you ought to give God really, really good praise, because that says that he's not finished with you yet, and the best is still yet to come for your life. Now, here's the thing about experiencing the best of God for the rest of your life. You have to be intentional in the things that you do. Many of you on the line some will say, I don't do New Year resolutions. Some will say, I'm setting my goals for the new year. I had my family, in our family chat, I had each one of them set their goals for the new year. What is your goals? Because every time there's a new year, there's a new season. Every time there's a new season, there's a new opportunity. So I had them to set their goals for the new year. And as I was writing the goals, writing my goals, one of the things I needed to do was I had to have a plan to execute each goal. And as my son's girlfriend said, wrote her list, she didn't call it a goal list, she called it a wish list, which is part of the problem. And then she said, I need your advice and how to bring my wish list to pass. And what I realized is that every goal list, come on, is a wish list until you have a plan for it to come true and become a reality. If you don't have a plan for what you set the goal to be, then it's really just a wish. And there's a 90% chance that goal would never be a reality, because most times, unattended, listen to the language, unattended wishes don't ever become a reality, because it's just a wish. It's a closing of your eyes and a hope that one day something will become. And there will never be a day that something becomes without your participation in the process. So if whatever your goals are for this year, the truth of the matter is it's only a wish unless you establish an executionable plan that will allow you to become a participant in the process of seeing that plan become a reality. I'm sharing this with you because I don't want your feelings to get hurt by the time you get to the 30th day of the year and realize nothing has happened. Nothing will happen until you make some things happen, because that becomes the works that the faith of your wish is attached to that causes your faith to work. Nothing, the quarter ended and you missed the mark. Most time we missed the mark because we didn't have a strategic plan for the goal to hit the mark. And so there's a couple of things as we position ourselves to win, because I don't know about y'all, all we do is still win, 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 no matter what. The only way we don't win is if we don't work. And the only way we don't work is that we don't want to win. Are y'all seeing this? And so it's going to the, so the easiest way to accomplish the goal is to be intentional and to be consistent. To be intentional and be consistent. To be intentional and be consistent. If you're not intentional and if you're not consistent, you will not achieve the goal. And now, the second thing that we need to understand in achieving these goals is that each goal must be very, very specific. It must be realistic. It must be time sensitive, right? And it must have executionable, non-compromising parameters built around it. What that means is, once you establish the parameters for meeting your goal, it's imperative that You do not allow anyone, watch this, inclusive of yourself, to compromise those parameters. In other words, do not allow the circumstances of your temporary situations to play a part in the delay and or the denial of you reaching the goal that you have established for yourself. Do, because the truth is, things are going to take place that you did not expect. But don't allow what you did not expect to hinder what you do expect. Right? Are you getting this? Don't allow what you do not expect to hinder what you do expect. Because sometimes we allow what we do not expect to be an excuse from intentionally and consistently pursuing what we said we do expect. And the manifestation of your goal, your dreams, your aspirations, you moving to the next level in business and in life is going to directly be connected to the level of your expectation. Because if you don't expect the thing, then you'll never receive that thing. Your manifestation will meet you at your level of expectation. And your level, and not only your level of expectation, but it's going to meet you at your level of execution. So there's no one to blame in 2023 if you don't achieve what you have set out to be, but yourself. No one should have the power to keep you from being the best you. Nobody can make you lose if you be intentional and consistent about winning. Truth is, stuff will take place. And we may not hit right at the point where we thought. But we have to continue to be intentional and consistent. And as you've heard Coach say all the time, you got to do the right thing long enough, consistent enough, and it will eventually be enough. May I encourage you that if you stay the course, irregardless of the detours that will come, if you stay the course, regardless of having to navigate potential roadblocks, if you're intentional and consistent about staying the course, and you do the work, at the end, you will win. Don't allow yourself the excuse that I'm going to take a break today and I'll just get back to it tomorrow. Because a break today hinders the momentum of your tomorrow. Now, I could go on and on and on. I'm in South Africa. And it's always a wonderful time here. I feel like God is just always speaking. But I'm going to stop there because the last few times we've been together, I have asked you for feedback because I want to make certain that what we give on Wednesdays, I want to make certain that what we're giving is helpful to what it is that you're seeking to do and what you're seeking to build in your business and in your life. So let's just take the next few moments before we jump off. Somebody unmute the call and let's get some feedback to our discussion for me this afternoon and for you this morning. Anybody, real quick.
This is Dan.
Yes.
This is, what you said was
Dan is not available on the
I can't hear you, Grace, but if you don't unmute the phone, you're not talking about the job.
Okay, Dan, I'm muting everybody back, and we're going to ask them to unmute one at a time because, you know, normally they were not unmuted, and so they're kind of open. So one person at a time, please. The gentleman was the one that was starting off, and I didn't get your voice. So could you unmute and ask or make the statement or ask the question of Coach Dan?
Okay. This is Benjamin Davis. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. As I'm listening to what Coach Dan is doing, is vibrating in my spirit, and it's vibrating breakthrough. And what I'm feeling is this needs to be repeated and heard to break through what Coach Dan is saying. It's powerful enough to hear, but we have to resonate what he's saying to get in our spirit to activate what he's saying so we can manifest what we feel in our spirit. So I appreciate this morning.
Awesome. And so Dr. Roz, this yes. is recorded. So she usually makes the morning calls available because I agree with you, Benjamin. So yes, it is recorded though.
Phyllis?
Yes.
Can you hear me? Good morning. It's Dr. Roz here. And I want to say, Coach Dan, thank you. So on point for me, especially today. We've been out of town. We just got back home. We came back home to a ceiling in our kitchen that had caved. We came back home to floodwaters all over the house. So we're stripping carpets and tiles and all this kind of stuff. But this does not deter me from being Diamond walking across the stage in April. This does not deter me for ranking our team members that want to be ranked and helping them to do the things they're going to do this year. Thank you so much.
Awesome. We're going to be praying for you.
Hey, good morning, fellas. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Hey, Gerald West from Chicago. What Coach Dan spoke today is something that we even hear on Success Academy training. And having an opportunity like this, just being the average person, having get an extraordinary, non-average opportunity like we have at this point, being able to be around what I call heavy hitters like yourself and Coach Dan, and just the C-suite period, is not to be taken for granted. What Coach Dan spoke this morning were key reasons why I had the opportunity to achieve Sapphire, why I understand that I will be getting a free trip for two to Las Vegas, because it's like my coach Mooney says, there's no respect to person here. You guys have opened up a gate for us, and I just wanted to chime in and say thank you so much, Coach Dan. I wanted to thank the C-suite. I know I don't talk much on these calls, but I'm always on them. Just wanted to represent for the males because we don't really get heard that much, but we are here in supportive roles to our powerful women. Thank you, Coach Dan. Thank you, fellas.
Coach Dan, Jolie in Chicago. Thank you. for being you. I am truly grateful that you're one of my heroes, Coach Van. Shirley McLaurin is thanking the Lord every day that you bring to us what we need to have in order to be what we should be. Thank you so much, sir. My hero, Shirley in Chicago.
Is there anybody else wants to speak this morning? Well, I'm going
to
speak.
Hey, Phyllis, it's Bernadine. I have to just say this. Coach Dan, praise God for you and all the leaders, anybody who speaks life into our business. We have a phenomenal opportunity, and I listen to everything everybody says, and I take copious notes, and that do the right thing long enough, consistent enough, and eventually it will be enough. That's been a mantra of mine, and I just wanted to say thank you. I have so many notes, and I am so glad to hear that this is going to be part of the training so that everybody gets to hear what Coach Dan poured out this morning, because that was powerful. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yes, and Bernadine, I want to go on and say the same thing. I've been on this path since this new year. I've been studying the word. I've been studying the power of prayer and how you're supposed to. And what you just did for me, Coach Dan, I was going to be on this call anyway, but then Dr. Roz asked me to intro you. But I'm so glad that I didn't miss this call, because everything that I wrote down this morning in my quiet time is everything you affirmed for me today on this call. And you're right, Benjamin. It's one thing to I write it down, because that for me writing it down, it enters into my spirit. It becomes part of me. I can always go back and read it. I can always go back and say, oh, your day didn't go well. Did you practice those things? So I just want to thank you, my son, that is in South Africa, and I didn't even know you were going, but I love you, and I thank you anyway. So thanks so much, guys. This was a blessing this morning. It's like drop the mic, because you did.
Coach Dan, this is Dolores, and I just want to say intentionality and consistency. Manifestation, you said, meets at the level of execution. Stay the course, do the work. You've always said it, and we are getting ready to start anew, and I'm going to start at the beginning and move to the top. So just thank you for all your encouraging words every Wednesday.
All right. Well, thank you all so much. Thank you, Ms. Phyllis. I can't wait to see you. Hey, listen, you guys, go ahead and knock it out the park. Bernadette, I need you to do me a favor. Send me those notes like you normally do. And then also, Dr. Roz, here's the blessing. Sometimes God allows chaos to position you for what you wanted in the first place. So I look at it as you got a new kitchen. You got all of that stuff is going to be done new. It's a new house for a new you. In 2023. And so we look at it from that perspective, then it takes the pressure off. And while we're cleaning up, we're just saying thank you, because you know what's getting ready to come. And so have a wonderful, wonderful, supernaturally Akana kind of day. And I'll be seeing you guys. Can't wait to see you face to face, but definitely we'll be back in the place on next Wednesday. God bless and prosper.
Thank you.
Well, I've been sitting here all day. I've been sitting in this waiting room.